Hi, this is Josh Jacobson, Artistic Director of the Zamir Chorel of Boston. Here's a lively Hasidic nigun, a devotional wordless melody. Did you recognize it? It was composed by an anonymous Hasid, a follower of the Rebbe of Sadigora, a town in the Austro-Hungarian Empire, just prior to his aliyah to Jerusalem. In Jerusalem in 1915, the Sadigora Hasidim sang this nigun for the well-known ethnomusicologist Abraham Tzvi Edelson. Edelson was at the time collecting Jewish melodies from around the world for inclusion in his soon-to-be-published Thesaurus of Hebrew Oriental Melodies. According to Edelson, quote, in 1918, needing a popular tune for a performance of my mixed choir in Jerusalem in celebration of General Allenby's victory, my choice fell upon this tune, which I arranged in four parts and for which I wrote a Hebrew text, unquote. Here is an archival recording of Edelson's choir singing that song. The lyrics begin with a quote from Psalm 118, verse 24. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us exult and rejoice in it. Nagila v'nismicha vo. The song immediately became very popular, and I think we're used to hearing it in an arrangement like this one. In 1957, the Jamaican-American singer Harry Belafonte recorded his version of the song, which became very popular. Then in 1963, Dick Dale and his band released the surfer version of Hava Nagila. But the strangest version is probably this one, which Bob Dylan said he learned in Utah, released in 1963, the Talkin' Hava Nagila Blues.
Hava. Na Havana Gi Havana Gi.
Okay, well, now let's listen to the Zamir Chorel of Boston singing it in an arrangement written in 1948 by the young Israeli composer Daniel Faktori. Here's Hava Nagila.
Hava Nagila.